Right now at 5, here comes the rain again. A second of 3 storms due to arrive soon in the Bay Area, possibly bringing thunder and lightning with gusty winds. A lot of snow in the mountains as well. Meteorologist Carrie Hall has your hour-by-hour outlook. Plus,
not one more American life should be lost because our lawmakers failed to secure our borders.
President Trump to unveil a major new immigration proposal. We're live on Capitol Hill with who will be most impacted. And
the Sharks take game 3 in St. Louis, but not without controversy. The goal that everyone is talking about this morning. Today in the Bay continues right now. And a good morning to you on this Thursday. Thanks so much for starting your morning with us. I'm Marcus Washington.
And I'm Laura Garcia. Everybody's talking about the rain as well, and it's going to continue later today.
Yeah, another round of rain moving in. So a lot of us are waking up and walking out the door to some drying conditions, but there are still a few spotty showers still lingering. So let's get a closer look right now across the Bay Area. Do have some rain moving over the Santa Cruz Mountains and just now moving out of San Jose. That's pushing east. And then as we get a look at the San Mateo Bridge, it is pouring right now on that spot, and then it's not raining on the other side of the bay. So that's what's headed in as we go hour by hour. A new round of some heavier rain will develop and potentially some thunderstorms. We'll talk more about that in the timeline, but Mike, you had some spinouts reported.
Yeah, Carrie, so we had some smaller crashes reported around the bay, and with that rain, we'll track that and maybe catch a glimpse of that over on the Hayward side. But whether it's raining or not where you are, wet roadways continue around the bay. That's where all the green highlighting is. Be very careful. The latest spin out reported north 680 heading toward the Benicia Bridge. Just before you get there, car with some debris in lanes. Be careful, guys. Back to you.
All right, thanks, Mike.
This unseasonably late rain might be good for our gardens, but not so much for our roads, many of which are already packed with potholes.
Today in the Bay, Bob Riddell live for us there at Antioch. And Bob, I know you've spoken with a couple of men who plan to do something about all of these broken up roads.
Correct, Marcus and Laura, as you're well aware, potholes are a problem throughout the Bay Area, places like here in Concord, and especially farther west in Oakland, where the so-called pothole vigilantes are at it again, except this time they need your help. The two men who've been filling potholes in Oakland on their own time and dime, they're hosting a meetup tonight at Lowell Park in Oakland. They'll be handing out free tampers and bags of asphalt for anyone willing to make Oakland's roads smooth again. The vigilantes, who wish to remain anonymous, they've filled about 30 holes on their own over the past few weeks. They've garnered a lot of attention, and they've been able to collect almost $5,000 in donations.
We're just trying to inspire, like, some sort of a social movement to, you know, inspire the community to just fix the problems of their community on their own, and instead of like waiting on people. Ultimately, we would like to see all the potholes in Oakland filled, and hopefully that'll happen soon with not only our help, community's help as well.
All right, the Pothole Vigilantes meetup. Take a look at your TV screen. It's 9 o'clock at 8 o'clock at Lowell Park in Oakland. They're gonna have free asphalt tampers, shirts and stickers. Again, they're inviting you to come out if you want to help fill in those potholes that pock, unfortunately, a lot of the roads in Oakland and through other areas in the Bay Area. Reporting live here in Concord, Bob Riddell, today in the Bay.
Thanks so much, Bob, and stay connected with our free NBC Bay Area weather app. You'll have all the radar that we use right here in our studios in the palm of your hand. See where the rain is going and coming to you with our free NBC Bay Area app.
5:03 for you right now. And on Capitol Hill, President Trump is set to unveil a sweeping new immigration proposal today. Now, the administration says that it will emphasize skills and education instead of family. Today in the Bay's Craig Boswell, live for us in Washington with more on what to expect. Craig?
Marcus, good morning. Good morning, everyone. It's described as a two-pronged plan, and it faces an uphill battle in Congress.
On border security, President Trump's immigration proposal outlines border wall completion in 33 designated areas and scanning improvements at ports of entry.
Not one more American life should be lost because our lawmakers failed to secure our borders.
The plan's main portion mandates immigrants pass a civics test, requires language skills and education levels, shifting to a merit-based system from the current family-based approach, where green cards go to those with family ties.
We welcome about 1 million of our world's neighbors every year to come into our country legally.
The plan does not address the millions of immigrants already in the country illegally, the status of Dreamers, or touches on the Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals program, known as DACA, top priorities for Democrats.
I have a humanitarian concern created by the president when he eliminated the DACA program and left 800,000 young people with uncertain future.
The president also wants to adjust the asylum process at the border, where there's a backlog, and Homeland Security plans to deploy TSA agents to help with the migrant influx. Hundreds arrested this month alone.
We've seen a trend for sure of different hours in the morning, but they're after midnight is definitely a trend we've seen.
As for the president's plan, lawmakers from both sides say it's unlikely to get through Congress. Craig Boswell, NBC News, Washington.
It is 5:05 right now. Teenage vaping is becoming an epidemic. And new this morning, North Carolina is suing San Francisco-based Juul, the popular e-cigarette maker accused of manipulating and addicting a new generation. Today in the Bates, Pete Serrano's joins us live with more this morning. Pete?
Yeah, good morning, Tia Laura. Yeah, as you mentioned there, San Francisco-based Juul is being sued by the state of North Carolina. That's the home of big tobacco. Of course, they have a big history in that area. And the issue, according to the attorney general, is how this product is marketed to teenagers. Now, the state attorney general claiming that Juul has skyrocketed in popularity in North Carolina in recent years, saying teens between 15 to 17 are more likely to use these e-cigarette products. AG also says that Juul markets to these teens by infusing the liquid nicotine with fruity flavors and packaging it like flash drives so that they can be easily hidden. But Juul says their target market is adults and even supports raising the age for tobacco purchases nationwide to 21. Here's the AG at a news conference, or the state attorney general, that is, at a news conference in Raleigh yesterday, talking about another factor that led to this big lawsuit.
Juul entered the market with the highest nicotine potency of any product at a level so high that in a number of countries, the product is banned for people of any age. Meanwhile, Juul understated the strength of the nicotine in each pod, downplaying its risks.
And right here in San Francisco, Juul is fighting its own battle. In fact, they're fighting back against city leaders. They came up with a plan to ban the sale of e-cigarettes following a report on a spike in teen usage of e-cigarettes and vapes in the area. They just filed a ballot measure to block this ban. Now, they're going to need 9,000 signatures to get this on a ballot. They'll need to get those signatures by July 8th. Reporting live, Pete Serratos for Today in the Bay.
All right, Pete, thank you. 5:07 for you right now. And a top-ranking fire official on the peninsula faces serious legal trouble this morning, accused of propositioning a 16-year-old boy. Gary Carlson serves as secretary of the San Bruno Fire Department. And San Bruno police say that he passed a suggestive note to a teenager at Peninsula High School last week. Officers arrested him, and he is now on paid administrative leave.
Happening today, UCSF is advising patients to expect possible hiccups as workers hold another one-day strike. Today's strike should be similar to the one last month when healthcare technicians last walked off the job. Workers are angry over outsourcing. Today's picketing will center around the Mission Bay campus where UC Regents are meeting. Democratic presidential contender Julian Castro plans to join picketers at a noon rally. He's the former mayor of San Antonio. Castro not among the top contenders, but currently ranks fourth among Democratic Latino voters. Well, happening today, single-day tickets to Outside Lands go on sale.
Festival goers can expect a big lineup this year. 21 Pilots, the Lumineers, and Blink 182, a headline opening night. That's Friday, August 9th. The next big day, Childish Gambino and Hozier are among those top acts. And on Sunday, Paul Simon and Kacey Musgraves are among those big names taking the stage. Single day tickets start at $155 and they go on sale at 10 o'clock this morning. So, Carrie, you have some time before you get your tickets this year.
Oh, I thought you were going to say for the rain to clear.
That's
probably what people will be doing while they're sitting at work in front of the computer and it's raining outside off and on. And so the rain that we've been talking about has been definitely one we'll continue to talk about because it set a lot of new records. And in terms of how much rain we get on a daily basis for that day, we have our record of 0.29 in Santa Rosa, but look at how much we measured. I mean, we just blew that record out of the water. Over 2 inches of rain in Santa Rosa, and then we also had other daily rainfall records set in Oakland, Livermore, and in San Jose. It's still coming down. That's a live look outside at the San Mateo Bridge, where the drivers are heading out the door, having to deal with more of these showers. That will be the case as we go throughout the day, as we see still some spotty rain now, and then another blast of some rain, potentially some thunderstorms for the afternoon. I'll have the timeline of that on in just a few minutes. And Mike, you were concerned over a crash.
That's right, in San Jose, Carrie. So I'm glad that you were able to show that rain, having traveled across to the Hayward side on the San Mateo Bridge. Wet roadways continue around the bay. We're zooming into 87. Highway 87 does show some slowing right now, coming out past SJC there, San Jose Airport. Just as you make your way up that hill, folks familiar with the area will know that it rises up toward 101 in a transition there. Reports of a car losing control and going off of the roadway. The reason we're especially concerned is there's a lot of radio chatter. And if you notice from the map, even here, the 3D shows you there's a little hill coming up to the area. So anywhere along that rise, but the closer you get to 101, the bigger the drop. So we're tracking that. But so far, there's just that bit of slowing north 87 approaching 101. The rest of the South Bay, slick roadways. So watch out. There was another spin out here in North 880 at 237. Back to you.
All right, thanks, Mike.
Still ahead on Today in the Bay, more states gearing up to pass strict anti-abortion bans following in Alabama's footsteps.
And possibly new limits on foreign cars as well. But then again, what is a foreign car?
And get ready to dance with Maya Rudolph and guest host Melissa McCarthy on Ellen today. Break it on down, Maya, break it on down. Yeah, still ahead for your 525. Not just dancing, Maya sings Beyonce for Melissa.
What an entrance there. We need the start of our show to be something like that.
Oh, it's coming.
Plus, gone in 60 seconds, but back in less than 60 minutes. How a brewing company had its stolen vehicle back. You're watching Today in the Bay.
It's been a violent city. All we can do is react to that. We hear the community say that we don't care about them, and that's not true.
Lack of trust on both sides.
I'm tired of yelling about black bodies in the streets. Where do we fail?
Tonight, what's really behind all the police shootings in Vallejo?
Why do these young people have guns? Why do they need them?
Tonight at 11 on NBC Bay Area News, we investigate.
Drive yours home today. Now get F-150 with 0% financing for 72 months. That means over $10,000 in possible savings.
It's the Memorial Day sale at Mattress Firm. Enjoy one of the best mattress holidays with our best deals of the year. Get a king mattress for the price of a queen and a queen for the price of a twin. That means you can save up to $700 on the best brands. Plus, you can also get a free adjustable base with our lowest minimum purchase ever. We know our customers are raving about these deals, so don't miss out on our best deal of the year. Your budget stretches further at Mattress Firm.
Technology should be simple. Simple to connect with, easy to talk to.
Hey, BMW, where can I park?
And a joy to drive. Don't be driven by technology, drive it. The all-new BMW 3 Series. Hurry in to lease a 2019 BMW 330i sedan for $399 per month.
Did you know Comcast Business goes beyond fast with a gig speed network, complete internet reliability, advanced voice solutions, Wi-Fi to keep everyone connected, video monitoring.
That's huge.
Did you guys know we did all this stuff?
No.
I'm not even done yet.
Wow.
Business TV, cloud apps, and support.
Comcast Business goes beyond AT&T. Start with internet and voice for just $59.90 a month.
It's everything a small business owner needs.
Comcast Business, beyond fast.
Drive yours home today. Get Escape or Explorer with 0 for 60 plus 1500 trade assist cash. Or get Edge with 0 for 60 plus 3500 bonus cash.
Right now at 5:14, we are seeing some breaks in the rain, even a few breaks in the clouds over Walnut Creek, but that doesn't last that long. By 7 to 8 o'clock, rain chances going back up, and we'll see times of some rain throughout the day. And we do have a lot more of rain as we go into the rest of the forecast. We'll talk about how much we've measured and how much more rain we may see. That's coming up in less than 5 minutes.
How much more we'll see, but how much we saw is still left on the roadways. There's that beautiful lighting over here at the Richmond to Centerfield Bridge, but watch the conditions. Slick around the bay, lots of spinouts to worry about.
And a very good morning and a happy Thursday to you as well. Investors happy with news that President Trump may put off a tariff on foreign cars. More about that in a minute. Santa Clara's Agilent just plunged after the medical testing equipment company showed quarterly returns to shareholders. Microsoft warning about a very serious security flaw. If you're running a modern version of Windows like Windows 10, you don't have to worry. But Microsoft saying one of its most serious security risks it's seen in years. It's issued a patch. President Trump issued an emergency order barring U.S. communications companies from buying equipment from foreign sources, saying it protects America's security interest. Commerce Secretary Wilbur Ross then put Chinese company Huawei on a restricted list, which will prohibit American companies from selling their technology to the Chinese company. It won't be implemented right away, but it basically prevents Huawei from doing business either direction in America. Officials worry Huawei is too closely linked to the Chinese government, which might use the telecom company's equipment to spy on Americans. The president put off a decision to put tariffs on foreign cars. It would add 25% to cars made overseas, with the exception of South Korea. He will put that decision off for 180 days, but may ask foreign car makers to voluntarily limit their exports to America. There's already a limit, actually, on how many cars Canada and Mexico can send into the United States. So when we say foreign car, we mean something built overseas. But really, that's a weird word to use generally these days. I drive a Ford, all-American car. It's made in Mexico, right?
Right.
The single largest exporter of the Bavarian Motor Works SUV, BMW, is in South Carolina. So what he means is anything made overseas, exception of South Korea. But foreign car is a funny concept.
It's different. Yeah. It's changed dramatically.
Yes, it really
over the
has.
Years. Okay, good deal. All right, cars, vans. North Carolina Brewery serves up a unique reward to get its stolen van returned. The Unknown Brewery in Charlotte posted this photo to Facebook on Monday saying someone had taken it. Security of video actually showed the suspects getting into the van and taking off. In response, the business offered a reward only fitting for a beer company, you can imagine, saying they would provide a keg party for whoever found the van. And guess what? Sure enough, in just 42 minutes, that stolen van was spotted by a woman parked along her street. The Unknown Brewery is now honoring her with that keg party, tap rental fees included.
Wow.
So the Unknown Brewery is becoming pretty well known now.
The only thing is, what if the people who stole the van live in her neighborhood, and then she's having a keg party, and they know that she's the one who told on them?
Interesting.
I don't know.
It's like Dateline here this morning.
But then
morning.
They can benefit from and go to the party.
Well, it's a good thing that the name of that brewery was prominently displayed on the van photos that we're showing.
All right. Yeah, we'll be waiting to see what happens with that. All right. So let's talk about this weather this morning as we get a look at how much rain we've measured across parts of the Bay Area. In just 24 hours, San Anselmo measured over 2 inches of rain. Now that's more, almost double what you get normally throughout the whole month of May. In Boulder Creek in the Santa Cruz Mountains, over 2 inches of rain there. Santa Rosa setting a daily rainfall record of 2.1 in Richmond, an inch and a half. In San Francisco, 3/4 of an inch of rain in the Castro. And in San Jose, we had 3.36. So it's really been significant, considering that's also the amount of rain we get through the whole month of May. And we still have some lingering showers. Taking a look at the radar, mostly some spotty light rain, but in a few spots it's been pouring quite heavily. That rain that was over the San Mateo Bridge has now moved over toward Hayward and will continue to slow slowly push off to the east. We also have some rain moving through parts of Sonoma County, getting ready to approach Yountville in the next few minutes. So the rain off and on, but then it will get more widespread and heavy with the next batch of rain that moves in as that center of low pressure moves right over the Bay Area. And with that, it will force the air to rise fairly quickly, and that means we could see some thunderstorms, even the possibility of some small hail in some of these cells that develop this afternoon. So we get this along with some more heavy rain that could cause some more problems in terms of some street flooding just briefly, and then also some hail that may cause some damage, especially with all the new vegetation that's come out. As we go into tonight, we're going to see this rain taper off. We wake up tomorrow morning, still a couple of spotty showers, but the overall trend will be for our skies to clear, and we are going to see the next system moving in on Saturday. Overall, we're looking at an additional quarter inch of rain, and then when the next storm system comes in, we could see in the South Bay up to about an inch of rain in total. But look at how much rain we may see on top of what we've already gotten in Ukiah, over 3 more inches of rain. So this is really a significant system for this time of year. And as we go into the weekend, you're making plans for Saturday. Saturday morning looks good, but in the North Bay, we'll already see that rain moving in, and it quickly spreads across the Bay Area going into Saturday afternoon into the evening. And then as we look at Sunday, off and on rain throughout the day. Sierra snow still coming down by Monday. We're seeing this system clearing, but another one is right behind that. So we're not going to see the rain turning off in the forecast. In fact, it just stays unsettled from now through at least next Wednesday as our temperatures stay unseasonably cool for this time of year. Mike, you have another update for that crash in San Jose?
I do, Carrie. Let's take out to the maps. We're looking at San Jose. Let's start with a bigger view, because overall I do want to note that Carrie's talking about that rain that happened, more rain coming, and I think folks are tending to underestimate what she's talking about. Listen to the numbers, folks. We already had a lot of rain overnight, making these roadways wet and slick. A number of spinouts reported. There's more rain coming through the area, and I know it's just in waves, lighter at times, but still we are having reports of some water on the roadway, standing water, and one of your areas where we usually see that flooding right here, 87 come up toward 101. It is not the flooding that's reported, but in that same area with a tight turn, North 87 right there by the airport and 101 First Street. That's where this crash is causing some slowing and a lot of activity. We're still waiting for an update, but we hear about at least one person taken from the scene with injuries. Not major, but injuries nonetheless. Be very careful out there. Still wet roadways throughout the Tri-Valley. Coming out of the Altamont, a crash on the shoulder, West 580 just as you get through the clearing area. And here's 580 looking pretty clear as far as the volume of traffic, but across that Richmond Bridge, you still see those slick roads. Back to you.
All right, thanks, Mike.
521 right now. Coming up next, a serenade to Melissa McCarthy from Maya Rudolph on Ellen today. And it's a Beyonce song. We'll have a preview coming up next.
And a shout out to the Eiffel Tower, celebrating 130 years since it first opened. Well, you have until Friday to get to Paris to check out that special anniversary light show. If you're like me, you'll just wait to the next under 30 and check that one out.
Yeah, because that's tomorrow. You're going to jump on a flight.
Oh, yeah, let's go. All right. 522 for you right now. You're watching Today in the Bay.
NBC Bay Area, broadcast home of the Giants.
Strike three call.
Friday at 6:30, Bochy and the boys take on their division rival.
Deep into the night, a grand slam!
Giants, D-backs, Friday at 6:30 on NBC Bay Area.
How do you know you're in the presence of a legend? When there's not a break, drop, trail, or challenge they can't handle. There are many SUVs, but there's only one legend. Legends aren't born, they're made.
Well-qualified returning Grand Cherokee lessees get a low-mileage lease on the 2019 Grand Cherokee for $179 a month.
Let's go.
With quality ingredients, Nutella is sure to bring a smile to breakfast time. Show your appreciation with a limited edition Nutella jar.
It's no ordinary day at Denny's for our family. It's Crepe Day, a family tradition we started about 22 minutes ago. And from the looks of it, this tradition is going to last a while.
Denny's has new crepes.
See you at Denny's.
Man, that's a cool looking hot tub. Yeah, we should check on the baby.
He's so sweet.
Maybe too sweet? The internet's down.
Your home is only as smart as your internet. Get reliable AT&T fiber and get speeds up to 300 megabits per second in DirecTV. Bundle for $75 a month for 12 months. Limited availability may not be in your area. More for your thing. That's our thing. Call 1-800-CALL-ATT.
Today on California Live, Padma Lakshmi is dishing on the new season of Top Chef and time to warm up. We're learning moves from a teenage yoga queen. It's all happening on California Live. This morning at 11:30 on NBC Bay Area.
Get your home in shape for summer during Airport Home Appliances Memorial Day Sale. Hurry in today and get up to 40% off appliances, up to 60% off brand name mattresses, and exclusive rebates not found at the big box stores. Plus, get up to 18-month special financing and free delivery on select items. Shop early and save big all month long with incredible deals starting now at Airport Home Appliance. Unbeatable price, selection, and people.
Closed captioning provided by Airport Home Appliance during their Memorial Day sale.
Welcome back, everyone. 5:24 right now. A look at news making headlines this hour. Austria approves a ban on headscarves in elementary schools. The Guardian says Sikh and Jewish headwear are not affected. The Austrian government expects the ruling to wind up in constitutional court.
A missing toddler found alive in Kentucky. The Lexington Herald Leader reports that the boy disappeared from his home Sunday night. Yesterday, searchers found him about a mile away.
The Statue of Liberty has a new museum. It officially opens today. The New York Times headline suggests it will illuminate a forgotten history and add context for the millions of people who visit every year.
5:25 for you right now. And new overnight, Missouri's Senate passes a ban on abortions after 8 weeks of pregnancy.
In the meantime, Louisiana is moving forward with its own proposal to restrict abortions. The ban would apply once a fetal heartbeat is detected. In the meantime, Alabama's governor signed blanket restrictions into law yesterday. Abortion will only be allowed if there's a serious health risk for the mother. Violators face up to 99 years in prison. The new law is set to go into effect in 6 months, barring some kind of action from the Supreme Court. Also new this morning, a high school in Washington State is closed following a measles outbreak. Five new cases were just announced, and a staff member is among those infected. Parents are being told they must provide proof their child is immunized, or they won't be able to attend school until at least June 3rd. Might be a rainy day around here, but three funny women are spreading some serious sunshine on Ellen today.
Yeah, SNL alum Maya Rudolph is actually proving that even though she's not 21, she can still bust a move. She's got it all, the dancers and lights and everything. But the Wine Country star doesn't just show off her skills on the dance floor. She's also channeling her inner Queen Bee, Beyonce, to help calm the nerves of guests. Host Melissa McCarthy.
I've been drinking. I get filthy when that liquor getting to me. I've been thinking.
You got my eyes on my fatty daddy, I want you.
That's the drunken love song there. Actress Kristen Bell also stops by to give Melissa some tips on pinch hitting for Ellen there. And you can actually watch all of this. You don't want to miss it. That's today at 4 o'clock. That's Ellen. And make sure you stay tuned for NBC Bay Area News at 5 right after.
Coming up next, breaking news that we're following in San Jose. We're getting reports of a car that went into a house. A live report coming up next.
And we've got a May soaker moving through the Bay Area. A little bit of a break now, but our next round of rain right on the way. So we'll talk more about what you can expect where you live for today. That's coming up next.
Start your day with Today in the Bay and Pete's Coffee. Visit NBCBayArea.com/contest to enter for your chance to win a $25 Pete's card. We'll be giving away three cards each weekday through May 24th. Brought to you by Pete's Coffee. Download their app and order ahead.
They're the kind of storms that wreck your day. Or worse, when NBC Bay Area detects dangerous or disruptive weather heading towards your neighborhood,
we're tracking it on Storm Ranger.
We declare a microclimate weather alert, and that means you'll get live updates every 30 minutes on TV, continuous coverage on social media and online, plus weather warnings based on your location from the NBC Bay Area app. When storms hit, an NBC Bay Area microclimate weather alert keeps you prepared.
At the Bay Club, summer is the season for discovery. And with kids camps for all ages, you're sure to find the right fit for your Explorer. Adventure awaits this summer. Enroll your happy camper today.
Ladies and gentlemen, start your engines.
Northern California Honda dealers' race to save is on. Race in now for supercharged savings. Like a $189 a month lease on the legendary Civic, delivering up to 42 mpg. $249 a month on Accord, a Car and Driver 10 Best winner a record 33 times, and $249 a month on CRV, highly versatile and loaded with high tech. But you gotta get here fast. Our Race to Save event ends June 2nd.
Did you know that your kids can lose up to 2 months of learning during summer? That's why so many parents are enrolling their kids in the Kumon Math and Reading program now. Kumon keeps your kids engaged, advancing, and learning essential skills for success like focus and confidence. Kumon, where smart kids get smarter.
It's the handwritten card delivered to your door, signed by Rhonda. It's the national award we won for healthcare equality. It's the transplant procedure that didn't just save one life. It saved six. It's the $403 million we invested in our communities just last year. It's 1,000 things, big and small. Sutter Health.
At the Bay Club, summer is the season for discovery. And with kids camps for all ages, you're sure to find the right fit for your Explorer. Adventure awaits this summer. Enroll your happy camper today.
How are you liking the rain that's been hitting the Bay Area? Well, we're already tracking the next storm following a rare spring soaker. Taking a look at our radar right now that we use right here in our studios. Good morning to you and thanks so much for joining us. I'm Laura Garcia.
And I'm Marcus Washington. Let's head over to meteorologist Carrie Hall. She has been tracking every movement of the storm and she has an update for us.
There's more rain on the way. We've already had our first batch of some record-setting rain moving through yesterday. And we're going to add some more on top of that. And then as we look at the radar, it is snowing in the Sierra as you head up above 5,000 feet. Those snow levels dropping. And then we're also still tracking some spotty rain as you get ready to head out the door this morning. For your morning commute in Brentwood, you've got another couple of hours of some dry weather, but by 8 o'clock, if you leave a little bit later, those rain chances will go up and those temperatures holding steady, mostly in the 50s. So we'll talk more about the next round of rain and a potential of some thunderstorms. But Mike, you're starting again with that crash in San Jose.
I am, Carrie. We're looking at just that same little bit of slowing. Now, this is a critical part of 87 traveling up past the airport and joining it. Here's Brokaw. There's a Skyport, and we're looking up past the airport and getting over toward the transition where the roadway rises toward 101. Now, from what I heard from a couple of folks, you can see the activity, but it's off of the roadway, so a distraction. A slick roadways, that's the concern because that's a single car crash there. There was another single car crash north 880 at Dixon Landing Road off to the shoulder with a little debris crash over here out of the Altamont Pass for minor slowing, but that's typical in the area anyway. We are looking at slick conditions at the Bay Bridge as well as the metering lights turn on. The back of forms here, clouds in the area. We continue to have slicker conditions and spin outs. We'll talk about the North Bay coming up, guys. Back to you.
All right, thanks, Mike. Well, 5:32 right now, and breaking news for you in San Jose. A rude awakening in one neighborhood. This is after a car crashes into a home.
Today in the Bay's Chris Sanchez just arrived at the scene. It's in Alum Rock. What do you know, Chris?
Well, we know that this car has crashed into this home, and now that the tow truck is here and taking it away, we can see where it smashed into this home at Rose and Stewart here in Alum Rock. And it looks like the car may have just hit the porch, although underneath there is the foundation, so perhaps some trouble there. We do know that one person was transported by ambulance. We don't know if it was someone who was inside the home or if it was the driver of this car that smashed into this little yellow home here in Alum Rock. We do know that CHP was out here on scene and also the Sheriff's Department. So this is an unincorporated part of San Jose. The car is being towed away right now. We will keep you up to date. We've been asking whether or not alcohol might have been a factor in this crash and whether or not there are any serious injuries and what precipitated this crash in the first place. These are residential streets, so there had to be a reason why somebody might have built up this much speed in order to do this kind of damage to this home. But again, one person was transported. We did not see lights and sirens on the ambulance, so hopefully that person was taken to the hospital as a precaution. In San Jose, Chris Sanchez, Today in the Bay.
All right, thanks for the latest, Chris. It is 5:33 right now, and new this morning, we're learning the Bay Area is paying the highest energy prices in the country. That's according to a new government study out overnight. The Bay Area's gasoline prices are 38% higher than the national average. U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics also says we're paying 56% higher electricity costs and 57% higher natural gas prices. Electricity and gas prices could continue to climb. PG&E is now being blamed for starting the campfire. It was already in bankruptcy proceedings, and that means ratepayers could be looking at even more increases.
Well, starting today, your suggestion may be the one to help change the name for one North Bay school district. Dixie School District leaders have formed an advisory committee to review all suggestions and submit final recommendations to the full board in June. In a story we've been following closely here on Today in the Bay, the San Rafael District voted to remove the Dixie name. This is over ties to the Confederacy. Now, from 5:30 to 7 o'clock tonight, suggestions can be dropped off at Mill Creek Middle School. Drop-off boxes are also set up at all district schools.
It is 5:34 right now, and in just a few hours, testimony resumes in the Ghost Ship Warehouse fire trial. Yesterday in court, victims' family members wept as they viewed footage from a firefighter's helmet cam showing the inside of the burning warehouse. An Oakland Fire Battalion chief also broke down on the witness stand, saying the Ghost Ship fire was the most difficult one she's ever fought. Defense attorneys for Derek Almeida and Max Harris grilled the same witness after she revealed she did not know there were victims trapped on the second floor. Happening today, students at one East Bay High School honor one of their own killed over the weekend in a suspected drunk driving crash. Fremont's Washington High School already had a Memorial Day related event scheduled for this afternoon. And now they'll also be remembering Armando Canales. He and four other teenagers were in a car struck by a wrong-way driver early Saturday on Highway 17. Three other teens in the car were seriously injured.
In Contra Costa County, a group of parents are filing a class action lawsuit against a special needs school in Concord. That suit claims that staff at the Marcus School went too far disciplining their children. And one parent says that their child was picked up and then thrown against a wall for tossing a water bottle toward a staff member. Contra Costa County Office of Education is not yet commenting on the lawsuit, but a spokesperson does say that the school staff is on the cutting edge when it comes to restraint training.
A live look at Oracle once again, Basketball Central tonight. That's when the Warriors and Blazers tip off for game two of the conference finals. Warriors hope to keep that momentum going from game one when they beat Portland by 22. So they're expected again to be without Kevin Durant. He's out with that calf strain. In the meantime, for Sharks fan, win is a win.
Yeah, that's right. Team Teal this morning once again has the upper hand in their playoff series with the Blues. But in this case, you really got to hand it to the refs here. Sense of theme here? Well, here you go. The play right here sparking a world of controversy. In overtime, the Sharks won 5-4 to take two games to one lead in their conference final. Now, the hockey world is crying foul here because Timo Meier made an obvious hand toss, which you see right here, which is illegal. Now, because of all four refs missed that play, and that play is not reviewable, the goal by Erik Karlsson stood. Now, we're not kidding you when we say that the Blues fans, they will be angry about this one for a long time. Well, tomorrow is game four, also in St. Louis.
Okay, we'll just stop playing that now.
We
won!
We did,
need to celebrate right now, Mike, right?
We have that video, but we also have the final score, so we'll take the final score, guys.
I'm with you on that one.
All right, let's hit the ice again tomorrow.
That's right. Slippery on the ice. Slippery on the roadways, not because of ice, because of the rain that was happening overnight and continues to pop up around the Bay. Carrie's talking about those changes coming up, but we have the leftovers, the green. That's the road weather index. Slippery conditions. Still have a crash 87 around the airport for SJC. A crash out of the Altamont at North Flynn Road leaves a little bit of a slowing as well coming through the area. But Contra Costa County looks great getting over toward the Maze, no problem, until you look at the Bay Bridge Toll Plaza where the backup has formed. There's the North Bay as well. Damp conditions. You see a little puddling over at the truck stop over on the right.
I see in the future.
What's that?
the weekend.
But you know what else I see?
What?
More rain.
Great.
We do have more rain on the way for the weekend, and I know that's canceling a lot of plans. I had someone reach out to me on Facebook and say, we canceled our birthday party.
Oh, wow.
My kids had a swim party this weekend.
Get wet.
Go out and dance in the rain. All right, so as you get ready to head out the door this morning, still some spotty showers. Make sure you have the umbrella. We have some more rain, even some heavier downpours on the way. So once this storm system pushes on to the east, there is another one right behind that, and that's our weekend storm. We can see it on the way, and it's going to arrive as we go into mostly Saturday afternoon. But there are so many outdoor events. I know it's really affecting those plans. And then in San Francisco, we also have the beta breakers that will be happening. And so we'll have to watch out the forecast for that. And we also have the Kids and Kites Festival in Fremont on Saturday. And it does start out dry, but those rain chances go up as we go throughout the day. And it looks like by early afternoon, there could be some showers. And it may be a little bit too windy even for some of those kites out there in the morning. As we look at our Tri-Valley forecast, so the rain moves out tomorrow. Saturday and Sunday are pretty much a washout, especially on Sunday. And then as you're making your plans to head to the Sierra, more snow coming down, and we're talking about winter storm warnings in effect for the middle of May. And look at these high temperatures just above freezing on Friday in Kirkwood as we add up the potential of getting a couple of feet of snow in some of those higher elevations. So it's nothing like we normally see for the month of May, and definitely not beach weather as we check out Monterey's forecast, reaching into the low 60s with more of those showers moving through. So we'll talk about the next round of rain and the timeline that's coming up in about 3 minutes.
All right. Thanks, Gary.
It is 5:39. Coming up, Cal Fire confirming PG&E is responsible for the deadliest wildfire in state history, the Camp Fire. This morning, what the governor is saying about the utility's ongoing headaches.
In Washington, the president says he will be the final decision maker as to whether we go to war with Iran.
And he is back and better than ever. Take a look at that. Mick Jagger got the moves. Yeah, he's got a song named after that, too. Moves Like Jagger. Remember that one? Well, this is a post-heart surgery. Coming up next, we're going to talk a little bit about that, as well as an announcement.
This morning, something big is happening on Today.
Universal Orlando Resort is getting a taste of today.
Join Al live for the grand opening of the Today Cafe.
Inspired by our own Studio 1A.
Be there as we open the doors for the first time. This morning on Today.
Drive yours home today. Now get F-150 with 0% financing for 72 months. That means over $10,000 in possible savings.
Carpet, hardwood, luxury vinyl plank, and countertops. It's all here at the Floor Store. Not only will you discover the newest trends, but you can feel comfortable knowing the Floor Store guarantees the installation of your flooring or countertops for as long as you're in your home. It's a guarantee I stand by with every installation, period. It's one more reason the Floor Store is your Bay Area flooring authority.
The Floor Store's Memorial Day sale is now up to 50% off store-wide, 18 months free financing, and no sales tax.
One site, over 1,500 new and certified pre-owned vehicles. Shop the combined inventory of the Euro Motors Auto Group, Mercedes-Benz of San Francisco, Mercedes-Benz of Oakland, and Mercedes-Benz of Monterey. The shopping experience is completely transparent. And at 1-800-NEW-BENZ, choose your vehicle, value your trade-in, and apply for financing all online. During the Mercedes-Benz Certified Pre-Owned Sales Event, get 1.99% APR financing and 2 years prepaid maintenance on selected models. Go to 1-800-NEW-BENZ.com for your affordable Mercedes-Benz deal.
Grab your gear and head to Twin Pine Casino and Hotel for the May 100K Great Outdoors Giveaway, where you could win a Grey Wolf luxury travel trailer. Join us on May 25th for our grand prize drawing. Explore Mother Nature in style, only at Twin Pine Casino and Hotel.
All right, boys, time for bed. Listen to your mom, knuckleheads. Hand them over.
Hand what over?
Video games, whatever you got.
Let's go.
You can watch videos of people playing video games in the morning.
Is that everything?
I can see who's online.
I'm gonna sweep the sofa for it. Well, look what I found.
Take control of your Wi-Fi with Xfinity XFi.
Let's roll!
Now that's simple, easy, awesome. Get started with Xfinity Internet for $29.99 a month for 12 months. Plus, ask how to get $250 back when you switch to Xfinity Mobile. Click, call, or visit a store today.
Drive yours home today. Get Escape or Explorer with 0 for 60 plus 1500 trade assist cash. Or get Edge with 0 for 60 plus 3500 bonus cash.
Good Thursday morning right now at 5:43. We're still breaking out the rain gear today. Even though we're taking a break from the showers now, don't forget it before you head out the door. As we head over toward Campbell and checking out our temperature trend, we will still see some of those showers rolling through as we go throughout the day. So I'll talk more about what to expect. That's coming up in less than 5 minutes.
And we're looking at great travel times down the East Shore Freeway, but be careful because the volume of traffic is not the concern, it's the conditions. You see that slick conditions here at the Richmond to Centerville Bridge, and we're tracking those crashes, those spinouts as they get reported.
Thanks so much, Carrie and Mike. It's 5:43 right now. New this morning, police searching for two people caught on camera brutally assaulting a man in San Francisco. Here's a still of the attack captured by security cameras. Police say the victim suffered a brain injury. It happened on May 8th in the Tenderloin on Eddy and Mason Streets. Now here's a close-up look at the suspects. If you know who they are, contact police.
Happening today, we're expecting to get a first look at the suicide deterrent system set to be installed at the Golden Gate Bridge. Crews will show off the suicide netting now being ready for installation. Bay Area work is already underway, and by 2021, the bridge will include the stainless steel wire rope extending 20 feet out on each side of the bridge, as well as 20 feet below the sidewalk. 5:44 right now, and new details. Governor Gavin Newsom is pushing for PG&E to move faster in its bankruptcy case.
Newsom's attorneys are objecting to a request from the utility company. PG&E was seeking 6 more months to develop a plan to reorganize its business. This comes as CAL FIRE officially determined transmission lines owned and operated by PG&E started the deadly fire in Butte County last year. 85 people died and nearly 19,000 homes were destroyed. PG&E filed for bankruptcy due to lawsuits connected to the fires.
Well, the president says he and not his advisors will decide whether to attack Iran.
This as the Pentagon prepares for conflict, Scott McGrew.
Good morning. We've heard a plan to send 120,000 troops to the area, Laura, though the president calls that fake news. And of course, we have a carrier task group going. Air Force has repositioned B-52s. This morning's Washington Post, a headline that says that it's the president's men who want war, frustrating the president who does not. The Post says the president is frustrated in particular with John Bolton, his national security advisor. Bolton was one of the men who convinced President Bush to invade Iraq. But the president tweeted this morning, there is no conflict, at least not inside the White House. There's no infighting whatsoever, he says. I make a decisive and final decision. I'm sure Iran will want to talk soon. New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio, the latest to join our board of candidates for president, becomes the 23rd Democrat to throw his hat into the giant pile of hats. Surprisingly, being New York mayor has not been a stepping stone to bigger office. The New York Times points out it's been a century since a mayor has gone from mayor to be governor or member of Congress. No New York mayor has made it to the White House. President Trump has pardoned two men, a former California politician, Patrick Nolan, in prison for racketeering, and Conrad Black, who did time for fraud. He's also the author of the book, Donald J. Trump, A President Like No Other. We're watching everything that's happening in Washington. You can follow me on Twitter. I'm at Scott McGrew.
All right, thanks, Scott. Okay, so at 75 years old, one rock star is proving that he still has moves like Jagger, because he is Jagger and he is not missing a beat. You see right here, Mick Jagger showing off his incredible moves on Instagram. This is just weeks after undergoing heart surgery. Check him out. That man can move. So he's rehearsing as he prepares to head back on the road. The rock legend was forced to postpone a tour with the Rolling Stones. This is due to his recovery, including the show at Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. So we've just learned that show has been rescheduled for August 18th.
Wow. No wonder why he's so trim. You know?
Yeah.
A lot of energy.
That is a lot of energy. You know, I've always wanted to see them. I remember I did a story on them when they performed in Charlottesville like 15 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm like, man, I wish I had gone then. But I might try to hit
that
one
out. Yeah, exactly. You got to see the classics. Mm-hmm. There you go.
All right. Well, hopefully on August 18th, it's not raining.
I doubt that. But who knows?
Like, it's May and rain.
In the middle of May. So we are talking about, you know, more rain on the way. And the first round has already rolled through. It's snowing in the Sierra. And then we have the center of the low pressure, that upper level load that's working its way closer to the Bay Area. It's going to pack another punch with the potential of some thunderstorms as we go throughout the day. So heads up about that. Right now, we're kind of in between, but still left with some lingering spotty showers, especially in the North Bay, and then even one little cell that's moving through parts of the peninsula right over Menlo Park and getting ready to head over toward East Palo Alto. So that may affect your drive this morning. Also a shower that just moved through Petaluma, now moving through Lakeville and then heading over toward Big Bend and also Sonoma. And we have another shower rolling through Dublin right now. As you go up towards San Ramon, we are going to see some of the rain affecting the morning commute. Off and on rain, but then we start to see it becoming more widespread and heavy through 11 o'clock and 11:30. We could see definitely rain covering the North Bay. Then going into the rest of the day, that's when that energy starts to build up, and there will be the chance that some of these cells could produce some thunder and lightning. And then for the North Bay, it's still going to be raining. Some of our highest chances of seeing the thunderstorms will be in the East Bay, the South Bay, and then also off towards the east. So we'll be watching out for that as we go throughout the day. Still some spotty showers in the forecast as we head through today, and then it tapers off tomorrow. And then for Friday, we're also going to be watching out for more rain. Now, our forecaster, VNA Arana, keeping an eye on some of those rainfall totals. How much have we already measured?
Well, you know, Carrie, we work together behind the scenes daily, so we figured this was a great opportunity to really make sure you are covered. And here's a look at some of the 24-hour storm totals. San Anselmo got over 2 inches. Now, mind you, that is typically their monthly average. So in just 24 hours, they got what they typically get in 1 month. Not only San Anselmo, but also Santa Rosa, over 2 inches. Near Boulder Creek, we're talking over 2 inches. The Richmond area, just a little over an inch and a half. In San Francisco, over a half an inch. Now, San Jose, it may not seem like a lot, at just over a quarter of an inch, but this is just a monthly, this is what typically we get in San Jose for the entire month of May, and that's what we managed to get in 24 hours. So that's pretty impressive, especially considering it is May. Now, I know that a lot of people are wondering if we've got more rain on the way, so I'm going to go ahead and send things back over to Carrie. Yeah. Carrie, how's the forecast?
We do have a lot more rain on the way, and that's going to be the main story, as we are expecting an additional 1 to possibly 2, maybe even 3 inches of rain around Ukiah, Santa Rosa, another 2 inches of rain. And so we are going to continue to add up more on top of the rain we've already had. And not only that, but it's snowing in the Sierra. I wanted to show you some of our cameras that we have. This is Lake Tahoe Golf Course, where the temperature is 34 and it's snowing. And then that's a look at North Star. This is usually the scene you see in February, and this is a look at Squaw Creek. Snowfall totals going throughout the weekend may reach another foot, possibly foot and a half, and the winter storm warnings will continue. There's more snow behind that in the forecast, and check out these totals that the computer models are putting down. In Kingville, we could get another 50 inches of snow between now and next week, and it looks like we still have more rain in the Bay Area and more Sierra snow on the way. So really unusual to see all this activity going on, and we're not going to see this wrapping up to possibly through the end of next weekend. So I'll have more on that. Mike, you're tracking a crash on I-580.
I am, but Carrie, I just want to point out that you called out the winter storm warning, but not winter right now. So it's, yeah, unusual right here. We're looking here. This is usual. This is Dublin, West 580, typical of volume building as you're coming out of Dublin and in toward the Dublin interchange itself. 580, there is a crash I'm tracking. I've been tracking it for quite some time. West 580, your commute direction right around North Flynn Road. Just after that, everything clears up, and this is at most blocking one lane, but traffic is lighter through the area, so only the Altamont Pass shows the slower drive, and a little build for 580. Actually, it's 238 getting on toward 880 through that area at Castro Valley Y. No problems right here coming through Contra Costa County. There you go. Brentwood, also folks coming off of Highway 4 and heading down Vasco. We have not heard about any problems getting down toward 580. That's a good smooth commute there. Just the Bay Bridge Toll Plaza with the metering lights on. Avoid the Bay Bridge Toll Plaza by going under it using BART. No delays for that system or any of our other transit agencies. So that's a good ride. There's Palo Alto. Ooh, look, water falling right on the lens right now. Back to you.
All right, thanks, Mike. Well, happening now, there's a race against time in Shanghai. Rescue crews are desperately trying to save people trapped under a collapsed building. At least 11 people have already been pulled from the rubble. That building was being renovated when it collapsed, trapping some 20 people. No word yet on what may have caused the collapse.
552 next, and all new this hour, a gruesome killing starting with a Facebook invitation for free baby clothes. The crime didn't stop with murder. How the pregnant victim's child is doing now, and the people police are questioning. Plus,
from my perspective, we are the first in the world to actually do this.
History making delivery in Europe. What this truck is missing. You're watching Today in the Bay.
NBC Bay Area, we investigate. NBC Bay Area, broadcast home of the Giants.
Strike three call.
Friday at 6:30, Bochy and the boys take on their division rival.
Deep into the night, a grand slam!
Giants, D-backs, Friday at 6:30 on NBC Bay Area.
Nuli gongzuo, hardworking. That's something my father's always taught me, to work hard. It doesn't necessarily bring you fame or fortune, but respect among your colleagues, your family, your friends, and hopefully success in life.
You know when you're at Ross and you find at a price that has you like,
okay.
That's yes for less. Say yes to the latest spring trends at 20 to 60% off department store prices every day. At Ross, yes for less.
Wow. Yeah.
There we go.
This Memorial Day, start your summer off right in a new Chevrolet.
Oh, wow.
It's time to upgrade.
You guys outdid yourself there.
I'm gonna go and get a Chevy.
An exciting summer begins at your Chevy dealer.
Current qualified competitive lessees can lease this Chevy Equinox for around $189 a month. Or during the Memorial Day sales event, get $1,000 bonus cash on these select Chevy models when you purchase.
It's a good day from morning to night.
Let's go.
With quality ingredients, Nutella is sure to bring a smile to breakfast time. Show your appreciation with a limited edition Nutella jar.
Every single sober day, I'm thankful I chose Mountain Vista Farm to help.
Mountain Vista Farm is a place where you can find a new life free of alcohol or drugs. Treatment is provided by a team of dedicated people who have the right training and the right experience. Many are in recovery themselves, so they understand and care.
Mountain Vista Farm gave me back my self-respect.
If you or someone you love needs help, call Mountain Vista Farm today.
You know when you go to Ross and find exactly what you need?
Yes.
For your growing family?
Oh, my baby girl.
That's yes for less. Everything your pet needs at 20 to 60% off specialty store prices. At Ross, yes for less.
Get synced in with NBC Bay Area on Instagram. I'll see you there.
Our team, always on social media. And do you need a cup of coffee? Well, today in the Bay's Mike Inoue does. He's actually sharing this photo of his cup of joe on Facebook. He writes, quote, after doing the math, you'll see the number on the mug signifies our 15th wedding anniversary, and the coffee signifies our crystal anniversary. Happy anniversary to Mike and his wife. You know what? Be sure to follow Mike on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and be sure to share your photos with us.
Aw, congratulations to them. Except I don't think that's the kind of crystal she was talking about.
I don't.
Just saying, Mike. 5:56 right now. New video this morning of a historic first in driverless delivery.
A Swedish startup debuted its driverless truck, and it will make daily freights and deliveries on the public road, and did so this morning, which the company says is a world first.
I mean, history is created in small steps. The first flight of the Wright brothers was 300 meters. This stretch of road is actually 300 meters as well. So we are bound to take and keep pushing history forward. And that, like I said, it's happened in small steps, but this is a giant step for autonomous electric transport.
Now, the CEO also says that his company is in talks with major suppliers to help increase production and delivery orders. Next year, the company plans to apply for more public route permits and is planning to expand here in the U.S.
This story is a hard one this morning, a tragic ending in the search for a missing woman in Chicago. Police say she was murdered and the baby she was carrying forcibly removed. That child is now in the NICU. Right now, two men and a woman are in custody. The victim's family thinks she was lured to her home where she died after connecting with someone in a Facebook group. She thought she would be getting free baby clothes. Neighbors are in shock.
It just doesn't make sense. Like, I don't know what kind of people those are. Not human.
The family says the Facebook group in question is now shut down. Vallejo police find themselves under the microscope in the wake of yet another deadly officer-involved shooting earlier this year.
And to better understand what's causing the shootings, our investigative unit dug deeper into the numbers and spent last month following officers on beat. Senior investigative reporter Stephen Stock takes us behind the scenes of shots fired.
We crunched the numbers and discovered that Vallejo police have the highest per capita rate of fatal shootings in Northern California, the third highest in the entire state. We wanted to know why. So we spent time on patrol with officers as they interacted with residents there. We also talked to stakeholders from around the community, a community with a high violent crime rate. We discovered several issues, including underpaid, inexperienced, and overwhelmed police officers, as well as a lack of diversity among the ranks compared with the diverse groups of people who live in Vallejo. Are there things you can do better, more diversity, more training, in order to reduce the number of these shootings?
Certainly, you know, we should strive to do better every single day, but we're only focused on a police problem. We're not considering that there's a community problem. Why is our crime rate so high? You know, why are these shootings occurring?
Coming up at 11, we investigate the reality in Vallejo and we'll show you firsthand what it's like when the guns are drawn and death is only a hair trigger away. That's later tonight at 11 on NBC Bay Area. We'll see you then.
Thank you, Stephen. 6 o'clock right now, a sweeping new immigration plan from the Trump administration. The proposed test requirement and new fees that would be collected at the border.
Yeah, I thought it was cool. It turns out it wasn't. I actually went to rehab for 40 days in California.
Stopping smoking. An East Coast state files a suit against San Francisco's Juul. The claims leaders and young people are making against the e-cigarette maker.
And pothole problems as Kerry is tracking more rain moving into the Bay Area. This morning, there's a new push to get you involved in the situation. Today in the Bay continues right now. A very good morning to you. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Laura Garcia.
And I'm Marcus Washington. Mike's going to give us all that we need to know about that morning commute this morning. But first, we want to start out with that weather, Kerry. And you're saying the next storm heading our way now?
Yeah, it's heading in and we'll see the rain kind of picking up as we go throughout the rest of the morning. And so we are also going to be tracking some thunderstorms. Really unusual.